different types of bonds: dormant bonds, plain vanilla bonds or snake bonds, zero coupon bonds, flexible bonds, and bonds with embedded options, CDs, convertible bonds, okay, callable bonds and putable bonds. Government bonds, as the name indicates, issued by the central government or state government. As it was mentioned earlier, these government bonds are issued by the government on, the government, RBI provides the, RBI, they need to get permission from the RBI, and they issue bonds, RBI issues bonds on behalf of the government. Okay? So these bonds, whenever the government issues these bonds, all the government-owned undertakings, it is compulsory for them to buy. So all the government-owned undertakings are forced to buy these kind of government bonds. Okay? Then, straight bonds or plain vanilla bonds. Plain vanilla bonds or straight bonds. S-T-R-A-I-G-H-T, straight bonds. They are bonds which carry fixed maturity period, coupon rate of interest and principal repayment. So there is a fixed rate of interest and fixed rate of maturity period. It's called what? State bonds. So all the bonds are called what? State bonds. The moment any company issues any bonds, it's called state bonds, plain vanilla bonds. Okay? Then another important type is zero coupon bonds. The bonds which don't carry interest. It is called zero coupon. Coupon here means interest. Coupon here means interest. Zero coupon means interest free. So how does company issue zero coupon bonds? I mean, when the interest is not there, who will go and buy these bonds? So they issue at deep discount and ready at par. So zero coupon bonds are also known as deep discount bonds. They are also called deep discount bonds. Deep discount bonds. Meaning to say, these bonds are issued at discount and ready at par. So these zero coupon bonds will have a higher face value, longer maturity period, with no interest. What are three features? Three features are longer maturity period. The usual maturity period is between 7 years and 9 years. Zero coupon bonds may have 12 years, 15 years, longer maturity period. With a higher amount of face value, usually bonds face value is 1,000 rupees. Zero coupon bonds face value may be 10,000, higher face value. Okay? With no interest. Why with no interest? Because it is issued at what? High discount. So high discount, what we meant is, for 10% discount, 10,000 rupees of bond face value, so it is issued at 9,000, it is redeemed at what? 10,000. So you pay 9,000. And then when the after maturity period, you will get back 10,000. So 1,000 rupees difference is called what? Interest. Interest is not paid annually. The interest amount is difference between issue price and the redeemed value. So you get back 10,000, but you pay 9,000. So 1,000 rupees is called what? Your interest. They are called what? Zero coupon bonds, or it's called deep discount bonds. Okay? Flexible rate bonds are flexible bonds which carry flexible rate of interest, which don't carry fixed rate of interest. The fixed rate of interest is in case of plain vanilla bonds or state bonds. The opposite of state bonds is called what? Fixed, flexible rate of bonds. Flexible coupon bonds. The interest rate will vary from 1 year to another year, depends on inflation. When the price increases, the interest rate falls. The price decreases, then the interest rate will go up. The interest rate will change, it depends on the inflation rate. It's called flexible bonds. Then we have bonds with embedded options. One is convertible bonds. Convertible bonds, they call it CDs. The issuer of the bond has got right to convert into what? Equity. The option is given to the receiver, the bond holder. The option is given to the bond holder. He can convert into equity, not the issuer. Issuer is issuer of the bond is a company. The receiver of the bond is the bond holder, the investor. So investor has got the right to convert into equity. This convertible bonds. So in convertible bonds, the companies carry very huge amount of risk because the companies, when the investors are converting into equity, then the investors lose its own, the companies lose its own ownership. So it carries high amount of risk on the part of a company. So it is, they are called what? Convertible bonds. So here, who has got a right? But the company has got a right. The investor has got a right to convert into equity. Then callable bonds. Callable bonds means the issuer of the bond can call the bonds at any time. Bonds. The company can redeem their bonds before the maturity period. It's called callable bonds. Here the right is given to not the investor, the right is given to the company. The company can call back the bonds before the maturity period. It's called callable bonds. Puttable bonds, opposite to callable bonds. The investor has got right to redeem its bonds before the maturity period. So puttable bonds are not common in India, whereas callable bonds and convertible bonds are common in India. Okay? So what is more common in case of corporates? In case of corporates, more common is plain vanilla bonds. Plain vanilla bonds are more common in case of corporates. Zero coupon bonds are common in case of government bonds. All the government bonds are known as zero coupon bonds. Okay? So the moment the company, the government issues interest, it will be always semi-annual. Semi-annual interest payment. The government bonds always carry semi-annual bonds. Whenever government intends to issue bonds, it will be always zero coupon bonds. So the common used bonds used by companies are state bonds. The common used bonds used by the government are zero coupon bonds.